Hey everyone, welcome to Denver Senpai channel.
Yo, I'm Sabina.
My name is Alex.
And today we're watching 24th episode of Frieren, Beyond's Journey's End.
The second round is going on in some King's Tomb dungeon. Pretty dangerous place to be in.
And meanwhile, Duncan actually got attacked by the replica clone of the Frieren.
They're all dead.
Yeah, we'll see. And I want to remind you that we have Patreon channel, so if you're interested in early access, full uncut reactions, please join us there.
Link in the description. Let's get it started.
Yay!
The Lord of the Dungeon.
There is a Lord.
Spiegel wa dungeon ni hairikonda jinbutsu no kiyoku
wo yomitori.
Taishousha no fukusei tai wo tsukuridashite iru to kangaerarete iru. Gijutsu sae mo mohou shita kanpeki na fukusei tai da.
Yeah, that's the next level.
Naze Zenze-san ga kono dungeon wo shiken kaijou ni?
Kind of dangerous.
Fukusei tai wa jibun to gokaku no aite da. Gisei wo dasazu ni taosu ni wa reisei na jiko bunseki to chiimu waku ga hitsuyou ni naru.
Yeah, that lonely guy is dead.
Yeah.
Jitsu ni heiwa shugisha no kanojo rashii shiken naiyou da.
What's your idea of pacifism?
Mazui.
Run.
Denken.
Can you just go back and find another gate?
I guess she will follow them.
Oh, is he injured?
Yeah, it looks like it. Actually, badly injured.
Yeah, he needs to go.
Megane-kun, 分身魔法の専門家としての意見が聞きたいんだけど。
僕の名前はラントだって言っているだろう。
Oh, they met her.
あの複製体はどの程度まで完璧な…
ユーベル、君ってさ、黙ったら死んじゃうような。
よく観察してるね。 物静かだ。
記憶や人格まではコピーしていないってことかな。いや、多分喋れないだけだ。最初の襲撃の時。Oh, it's his golem, so he cannot go back.
Whoa. Damn, I like this character. I didn't want him to die.
こちらに対する知識もある。僕たちを追い詰めたのに追撃してこないのは。それか、いたぶるのを楽しんでいるかだね。Probably
both.
わあ。ひどい出血だ。ディアン。メガネ君さ、このままじゃ長くないよ。そうだね。じゃあメガネ君、ちょっと待っていてね。ウェイト、ヒーディナイドヨーリーム。ビームを取り返してくる。まあ、距離を詰めてくるよね。ソルガミールの発動条件は 視界に全身を収めること。But she can cast or grenade on you as well。この勝負は先に距離を見誤った方が負ける。私は昔から運が悪いから、運で決まる勝負は嫌いだ。だから私は私と戦いたいとは思わない。She
won. Oh, she's gonna use it on her.
やっぱり運が悪い。だから嫌なんだ。
Oh.
でも、そっちの方がもっと運が悪かったみたいだ。メガネ君、意外と早かったね。
Okay.
Teamwork. So it was a clone all this time.
Wow, he's not that simple.
This
is fun.
メガネ君はさ、私の瓶を受け取ろうとしなかった。自分のせいで誰かが死ぬのが嫌なんでしょ?
だから私はメガネ君のせいで私が死んでしまう状況。That's why?
ありがとうね、メガネ君。
そろそろ共感できそうか?
But what will happen as soon as she will have this power?
Ooh, that would be dangerous.
Fern, just show me the map.
Something is off.
この壁の奥に隠し部屋がある。きっとお宝だよ。
Of course.
この雰囲気、ひょっとすると珍しい魔導書が眠っ…でも、入り口らしきものはどこにもありませんでしたし。確かにね。
She was right.
Interesting was there. Wow.
With the fancy entrance.
Okay.
It definitely should have something here.
埋葬された王の功績が描かれているな。これほど保存状態のいい統一王朝期の壁画は初めて見た。
Wow, she never been there too?
Mm-hmm.
壮観ですね。本当に順調すぎるぐらい順調ですね。
They actually never met replicants yet?
Oh, they're meeting them now. Time to fight Fern.
構造的にこの先の広間を越えれば迷宮の最深部だ。
それで？
あれが陣取ってもう半日になる。
Oh, so Frieren will fight Frieren.
Seems so. But she will have some help.
うん、面白くなってきた。ダンジョン攻略はこうでなくちゃ。
Okay, she's excited about it.
あの複製体を何とかしない限り、最深部へたどり着けん。何か手立てはあるか。
格上の魔法使いを倒すとしたら、高速魔法か。
名刀で。そういう小細工は得意だろう。
では失礼して。これは興味深い。高速魔法が通用しませんね。いい匂い。フリレンさん、次は私の目を見てください。精神操作魔法も無理ですね。心防御が破れません。あらあら。精神魔法の専門家なら脆弱性をつけるかもしれません。
受験者の中で心当たりは？
エーデル二級魔法使いなら可能かと。正直ここまで来られるかどうか。
So this is like the very last door.
Wow, they're that close.
心がないと通用しません。果たして複製体がそこまで再現できているかどうか。
エーデル、あれは何だと思う？
Whom they met?
Oh my god.
一級魔法使いゼンゼと同等の力を持っていると考えて間違いや。
Oh, sense is there as well. Wow. Replica.
もう倒すしかない。
倒せると思うのか、ブライ。あの紙には幾重もの魔法がかけられておる。このダンジョン内でも無数の手段で戦えると考えていいじゃろう。
Yeah, I'm curious what they're gonna do. What is the solution?
わしの見立てではあれには勝てん。
Yeah, you just retreat.
魔法はイメージの世界。普通の人間とはかけ離れたイメージ。わしらよりもはるかに格上の魔法使いじゃ。そもそもわしらは武闘派ではない。ここいらが。
Really?
If you assess the situation, yeah.
エーデル、お前の声は通らないのか？
できるとすればせいぜいひざまずかせて隙を作る程度じゃ。それでも目を合わせて声をかけねばならん。
不可能ではないんだな。
But it's hard.
どのくらい時間を稼げば。
15秒じゃ。というかそれが限界であろう。
どういうことだ？
Scary thing.
今にわかる。
Oh, found them. They have to rush things up.
防御魔法を破る方法は2種類じゃ。質量で叩き壊すか、技術でかいくぐるか。
Or find the weak spot.
驚いた。まさかその両方がある。防御魔法の全面展開は15秒が限界だと考えていたが、
They cannot defeat her. Oh, she succeeded?
She died?
Just different level. Damn, they miscalculated a lot. She needs to use Golem.
Yeah, makes sense.
Damn, those golems are powerful. Yeah. Other group needed her power as well. Mm-hmm. But now we know that it wouldn't work anyway. That's why she entered the dungeon. For her replica being there. Lonely guy is depressed.
I
like that their fighting styles are the same of those replicas. He looks smart in them. Your replica should as well. Fist fight.
Oh.
She knows her the best. She should know some weaknesses.
Yeah, to win Frieren for sure they need a good strategy, but there's a lot of people so they can come up with something solid.
Yeah, they should use some ideas that Fern has about Frieren after having an adventure with her for many years.
Mm-hmm.
Frieren could be unaware of her own weaknesses all this time just because she just didn't notice them, but Fern noticed them for sure.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure they will succeed, and she's smart enough to notice little details. Totally. Also, we have this guy with the killer girl.
Yeah, they're two together and they seem to be okay so far.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad. I hope they will pass as well. I find them interesting as the characters. Also, we have another group of people who fighting themselves right now. This dude with fur on his coat.
Seems like he's experienced and smart enough to know how to defeat him and his group. So he will probably succeed as well. The lonely guy, they just showed the short frame of him just sitting like that. What's going on? So probably he will not pass.
Yeah, that was not a smart decision.
Two guys who left war with the girl who could use hypnosis.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that will pass. They probably will fail as well.
Only if they will meet up with some stronger characters, but I don't think they will succeed.
It really feels like a game, and with all these hidden rooms and some secrets hidden in those hidden rooms. So I see why Frieren could be curious about all this kind of stuff, because if you're really interested in magic and history, you could really find so invaluable things that you will never find anywhere else, and you could be the first person ever been in this room for like 500 years. That's really something that you would want to do if you have opportunity.
Yes, true. That's really dope. Also, very interesting strategy of the sense to go inside with all the contestants to have your own replica there.
Mm-hmm. She knew that that will happen.
Yeah, for sure. I'm curious how far this replica will go. Will this replica meet Frieren and those people in her team?
I think I start to understand why they're calling her a pacifist. It's not about that she doesn't accept violence and she's like that kind and nice person all the time. She just doesn't want people to become first class mages because it's too dangerous. Their life will not be good if they will become that, so probably her idea is like, I will make sure that everybody is failing, so because apparently as soon as you have it, like you're in some kind of register, a lot of powerful people want to have you. That's my idea of why they're calling her pacifist for now.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think she's that simple, and probably, honestly, she calling herself pacifist, I feel like it's some sort of irony or something.
She's not the only one. Another proctor guy, he also calls her pacifist.
Mm.
So it's not only her opinion. He agrees with that.
Well, in that case, yeah, maybe she just don't want them to go further.
Yeah, could be correct. Or could be not. Thank you for watching this episode with us. Like this video if you like it. Subscribe to our channel if you'd like to see our future reactions.
Leave a comment below what you think about this episode, which was pretty interesting, but no spoilers. And see you in the next one.
See ya.